Good morning, we're so glad you're here. We daily vlog, so if you enjoyed today's video, make sure you come back every day. I'm driving home from the grocery store, and I think Dream Defenders is out on Park Avenue in Winter Park, and I want to see if I can drive past and find them so I can give them a couple honks, because they deserve the honks, they deserve the support. Alright, it's pretty quiet here on Park Avenue. Well, I see two protesters there. I wonder if they marched. I saw one of the coordinators that I've seen before from Dream Defenders sitting over by that fountain that they usually stop at on runs. This is where I saw one of the Dream Defender coordinators, but maybe they went to go march. So I'm gonna go like two more blocks that way since Aldi didn't take much time at all for me to go grocery shopping today. P.S. Everybody give a shout out to Dom and Kelly. Congrats, Dom and Kelly. I bumped into them in the store. They just moved here yesterday during all those storms and tornadoes and everything. So welcome to Florida, Sunshine State. You're gonna love it. It's gonna be so much fun. Just gotta wait one more month and all these theme parks will be back open and you guys will be enjoying the Florida theme park life. Congrats. Here we go, here we go. I found them. It was a good crowd. I had seen the advertising for that one kind of last minute, but I'm going to a different one later with the same kind of group of organizers that I've been with for the past week. But Dream Defenders is a good nonprofit organization. They do a lot of work with the Community Bail Fund of Orlando. That was a good crowd. Okay, I don't think my friend Sarah, you know, Sarah Brookhart, Sarah Marie Brookhart, my wife. There she is. Hey!
it's a lazy Sunday.
Sarah's mom woke up Sarah by FaceTime because she had heard up in Chicago about the tornadoes here and wanted to make sure we were okay. And Sarah picks up the FaceTime and goes, "It's a lazy morning." but I come around the corner from just like scrolling, checking out what's going on with protests today as Sarah's like was already loading up the vlog for the day. Look at this delicious, like, lunch salad she's sprucing up from the pearl couscous that she cooked yesterday.
I cooked the couscous a little too long, but break it up.
Delicious! I got T-minus 2 hours, a little less than that, before I head out.
Is it that soon?
Yeah. Ooh, that's not the right sign. That's the right sign over there. We're at Shadow Bay Park meeting today. I think we're just parking and meeting here. I think we're gonna walk up back out to Turkey Lake and end up marching Dr. Phillips area. But early day, early start, and I think this park closes at 8, so I think we'll have to cut back and get out of here by 8, but there was already a police sheriff by the front, so I'm sure they're aware of it. Should be good.
So our de-escalation tactics, we want not more funding to go to training because we've tried that, right? We tried that 3 years ago, tried that 6 years ago. We put a lot of money into retraining police officers. We got them body cams. They just turned them off. So our de-escalation point needs to be held by a community standard. We would like members of the community to be able to step in when we see police using brutal tactics, okay? Or excessive force. We need to write legislation that allows citizens the right to step in, okay? Because we saw this happen with George Floyd. I personally never watched that video, but there were 20 people standing around filming that man die. We need to start tracking police brutality. We need to start tracking excessive force. We need officers to be held to the same standard as our medical professionals. We need, if you violate and use excessive force, we need to be able to track that. We need public records of police transfers, okay? Why does only 20% of OPD live in Orlando? That's, they're policing communities that they don't know anything about, okay? And I had a conversation one of the very first days that we were out here with an officer that was in full-on riot gear. That's not necessary. We've been peaceful for 8 days straight. We've seen what's happened in Minneapolis, and we've seen what has happened in New York, and we are trying at all costs to avoid that.
No justice!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace! Black
lives matter! Hey, hey! Ho, ho! These race cars, I got to go!
Hey, hey!
There's Hogwarts during our protest.
And you're silent!
And you're silent!
You are compliant!
You are compliant!
Hello from home, everybody. I am just wrapping up some of the research I've been doing while Peter's been out today. I actually signed up to do some letter writing to ask people to vote, and that's going to be done via the vote writers and like a Skype session. So that's really cool. That's like the biggest thing I'm excited for. Just some really great information today. I shared a lot of it on Instagram, so if you're not following us there, I posted a lot today. A little bit of news on the Disney Vacation Club front. Our trip for June 15th was officially canceled by Disney, and we have 66 points that we have to use by August. And so tonight, Peter and I might be booking a Disney vacation stay, which is really, really going to be awesome. You guys know that there's a couple of things we want to do at the Grand Floridian to celebrate our pregnancy that had always been like on our radar. And so hopefully we'll get to do that and enjoy some time off at a Disney resort. We don't know if it'll be when the parks are open, if we'll even go to the parks, the details of it, but we will talk about it tonight, and that is just exciting and so on. Like, planning a Disney vacation is half the fun. But before Peter gets home, I'm hoping to put away dishes. He cleaned all the dishes. I'm gonna put them away and clear out the dishwasher, fold the laundry, and watch some Queer Eye while I do it.
Black Lives Matter!
We got Portofino Bay right there. We got Vineland all to ourselves.
We are peaceful. We are peaceful.
On his neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds. He could not breathe.
We are laying here for 8 minutes and 46 seconds. 8 minutes and 46 seconds. Just as George Floyd died in that time and laid on that ground, we will honor him in the same exact way.
Check it out. Day two of the rain starts. It is pouring on everybody. Shorter today, but very, very good. I thought it was a puddle in my shoe. Worth it.
For dinner, I made some spicy red curry veggies that we're gonna eat over rice. I'll probably make a salad too when Peter gets home.
Guess who's home and changed? Shout out to King Dave. Seashon Vlogs. He's the best. It's 7 o'clock and I'm home already. And
it's pouring
rain. I do need to go on an 8 mile run as my Saturday long run, but I think I told you guys I shifted it to today because today, Sundays are my rest days for my Chicago Marathon training. Fingers crossed Chicago Marathon happens in person and not that it gets canceled, postponed, or virtual. I'd rather it be postponed than virtual or canceled though. But my training schedule, and maybe I'll post it on our Facebook page so everybody can see it. But I need to run 8 miles as a long, easy run. But I'm gonna do it later because it's raining. It just dropped like 10 degrees, but I needed to stop raining and dry a little bit. Plus we're gonna eat, so we're gonna watch one episode of the new Queer Eye, season 5.
Yep.
I can't believe there's already 5 seasons. And then we're gonna watch Doctor Strange, which, how have I seen this and you haven't?
I don't know.
That's something we'll have to figure out, but I've seen Doctor Strange, but I love it. It's my kind of like movie. Sarah hasn't seen it, and it's gonna be great. So we're gonna do dinner, Queer Eye,
Doctor Strange, run, Party Express.
Doctor Strange was a good one. We only have Thor and then the last two Avengers movies in our long, drawn-out Marvel movie marathon. We watched a little bit of Queer Eye. Peter still has some work going on. And, yeah, hopefully we'll be going to bed soon, but I'm going to do the message.
You get a double daily message today since we missed yesterday's. Ever tried, ever failed, no matter. Try again, fail better. Samuel Beckett. And then today's is, a happy person is not a person in a certain set of circumstances, but rather a person with a certain set of attitudes. Hugh Downs. I dig it. We think we got our Disney staycation situated.
We gotta figure if it works out with my work.
We don't have that much time to plan it because our use year expires in August. So we have a certain amount of points that we have to use in a short period of time, but...
It's a good problem to have.
Yeah. And so, like, we're just grateful that we live here and can just do a staycation and not have to plan something big. So we'll let you guys know when we have it set. Do you want us to just sign off now?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's good to be home.
It's good to be home.